Now, this is one more type of a failure. We call them as punch out failure. We call them as a punch out failure. What is happening here? One particular area is itself broken. A particular area is itself broken, which may be weak, which may be weak in strength, or a vehicle path is on this one only. Heavy vehicle continuously, which are moving on this area only. So eventually, it is going to broken. Eventually, it is going to broken. Okay, you can see irregular pattern of cracking. Irregular cracking pattern. You can see a localized area. A localized area of concrete slab is broken. A particular area is itself broken into pieces, which will be named as punch out. Okay, this distress can take any shape or any form. These are mainly defined by joints and cracks. The joints and cracks will mainly keep 1.5 meter width. Okay, these are generally keeping 1.5 meter width. The main reason behind this punch out is heavy repeated loads, which are called as heavy repeated loads, and slab thickness inadequacy means in that area if slab is less thick, then this may cause. And foundation support loss means if underneath subgrade, subbase, base, binding, if they are not there in a proper way, then it is called punch out failure. And construction deficiency like honeycombing means concrete mixing procedure is not done suitable way, then that is also causing what? Punch out failure. Next thing is linear cracking. What do you mean by linear cracking? Okay, what do you mean by this linear cracking? See, the crack is throughout the panel. The crack is throughout the panel. That is why we call them as a linear cracking. What is happening here? These type of failures in rigid pavement divides the slab into two or three pieces. Means a concrete slab of 7 meter may be divided into 3 meter, 2.5 meter, like that it is divided, but it is not structurally done. It is due to the deficient part. Okay. And the reason behind this is the traffic loads at repeated levels, the continuous movement of the traffic, which will cause the linear cracking. The curling due to temperature, the curling due to temperature, and moisture loading means continuous alternate wetting drying. Alternate wetting and alternate drying cycles may lead to the failure. This is called as de-cracking. This is called as a precautionary measures are nothing but proper design, so which includes correct grade of strength of concrete, placing technique, spacing of the joints, okay, compacting subgrade, providing better aggregate, better compaction, better surface finishing. This will lead concrete strength, a good quality strength. Okay,